Oh, there it goes. Oh, wow. You know, when it comes to experimenting, often the devil is in the details, and there's those small, minute details that make all the difference in the kind of results you get. So for this video, we're back in the lab with our vacuum chamber and a bunch of water balloons to see if this time we can actually make them explode. Now, the last time I tried putting water balloons in a vacuum chamber, I fully expected that once we drew a vacuum, those water balloons would start boiling and expand to the point where they'd rupture. But in fact, that didn't happen at all. The balloons just sat there and it was really anticlimactic. It was really surprising to me that the water didn't boil and the balloons didn't change shape at all. But I'm pretty sure the results in this experiment are gonna be a little bit different, because shortly after I put out that video, our friends at the Action Lab reached out with a suggestion. They suggested that the problem was we had our balloons filled with cold water. If we used hot water, it probably would have worked. So here's the premise of our experiment. We're gonna start off the very first test with a cold water balloon, and we're gonna position the neck of the water balloon facing upwards so we can push all the air out before we tie it off. We don't wanna have any air inside these balloons whatsoever. Now, based on our last experiment, I'm expecting cold water will have no effect. The balloon will basically just sit there. At the same time, we're gonna fill up another water balloon with hot water straight from the tap and place them side by side. And what do you predict is gonna happen? Are the balloons gonna stay the same? Will they both inflate? Will one inflate and the other doesn't? Put your predictions in the comments below. Let's see if you're right. The other question on my mind is, does it matter how hot the water is? Like, can we use hot water right from the tap, or do we need to boil it on the stove? Obviously, hot water from the tap isn't gonna be nearly as hot as near boiling water, but will it still work? Let's go put that to the test right now and find out. So we got cold water first. Beautiful. Now it's important to note, neither of these balloons actually have any air in them. We held them upright and we squirted all the air out. So any growing, any bubbling, anything that happens inside these balloons will actually be because of the difference in the vapor pressure inside the balloon itself. This one is cold, this one is hot. Let's see if our friends at Action Lab are right and see if it makes any kind of a difference at all. In they go. Perfect. Lid goes on, vacuum pump begins. I can actually see the pink one growing a little bit. Oh, there it goes. Oh, wow. Sweet. All right, cool. Let's turn that off and talk about what just happened. Did you see that? Did you see the difference? The blue water balloon did absolutely nothing. It just stayed there in place, kept its shape, but the pink water balloon, on the other hand, started growing, and then boom, hit this point of no return where it expanded tremendously, hung out for a few seconds, and then exploded. And then as soon as it did, you can see all the water in the bottom was boiling profusely. Now, I still got this under vacuum. You can see there's a lot of mist in there, so if we go ahead and release the pressure, let's see what happens. There's water everywhere, but it essentially clears the cloud. And our cold water balloon is exactly as we put it in. So yes, I think that lends credibility to the idea that hot water balloons will explode in a vacuum, and not only that, they explode with power and prestige. And you know what this makes me wanna do? Load up a whole bunch more and see if we can do it again. Clean up. All right, here we go with round two. I got three more hot water balloons, and I made these ones different sizes just so we can find out whether size makes a difference. Let's drop them in and find out. All right, lid is on, vacuum engaged. Crazy, crazy. Okay, let me talk about that for just a second. So observing this thing from a distance, I noticed the orange balloon did start to grow first, and then very quickly was followed by the yellow balloon. Now there was a short burst where the yellow balloon started to grow a little bit faster, but they eventually caught up, and then when the green one started filling up, they all got jammed in the container together. And then everything seemed to stop for a second until the orange balloon popped suddenly. And did you notice what happened when it did? As soon as the orange balloon popped and all the water rushed out, the other balloons began to shrink back down. That's interesting. The reason I think that happened is because the vapor pressure of the water now in the container was less than that in the balloons, and so the vacuum was sucking that vapor first. So theoretically, if we dump the excess water out of this container and turn it back on, we should be able to get that yellow and green balloon to pop as well. Let's see if that's really the case. Here we go. Yeah, see, look at all that water in there right now. All that water just floating around free is the reason those other balloons won't expand. If we get rid of that, I'm pretty confident we can get the other ones to explode. So I've just dumped out the water. These balloons aren't nearly as warm as they used to be. However, they are still warm enough, I think. Let's find out. Okay, I'm gonna stop it right there for a second because obviously there's still a little bit of water in there and it's fighting against that water vaporizing off the bottom and the water in the balloon. So I'm actually gonna dry it with a paper towel to make sure it's crystal clean and see if that makes a difference. I love the way that would shrink back down. Boom. Okay, you know what it is? These balloons have actually cooled down so much that they're not expanding as quickly as we want them to. So I'm gonna start a fresh batch with warmer balloons so we can get that pop reaction we're looking for. Yeah, if I feel these balloons now, they've cooled down quite a bit. I mean, this one's really like just room temperature. This one's slightly warm. We are seeing them expanding, but these aren't hot balloons anymore. They've cooled down quite a bit. So I'm gonna make up two new balloons with nice hot water, same sizes. We'll see how they do. All right, back, two new balloons, this time warm water. They're relatively warm, makes my cheeks tingle. So let's put them in, watch them grow. Cool. Very cool. All right, guys, well, I think that pretty much proves that hot water balloons in a vacuum chamber behave much differently than cold water in a vacuum chamber. And here's why I think that happens. The elastic resistance of the water balloons creates its own pressure and almost acts like its own atmosphere inside the balloon. Now, the vapor pressure of water in standard atmosphere has to overcome 14.7 psi at sea level for it to actually vaporize. That's why if we create a vacuum and reduce that pressure, it'll boil at much lower temperatures. But the opposite is true when inside a balloon. It's almost like putting a balloon over the whole Earth and compressing the atmosphere, which means the temperature would have to be much higher to get it to boil. And once the balloon begins to expand, the pressure inside is already less, which accelerates the reaction rapidly until the balloon is so enormous the skin ruptures. So guys, we learned something new. We learned a bit more about atmospheric pressure, vapor pressure of water itself, and saw the difference of how cold water reacts versus the hot water itself. And of course, a big thanks to our friends at the Action Lab for reaching out with this solution. You go ahead and check your YouTube inbox. I'm sending you 25 bucks. Thanks for joining us for this experiment today. We'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Oh, wow. Apparently putting balloons with water in the microwave makes them explode as well. Who knew? Oh yeah, look how fast that goes. That's amazing. Dang, that was only like 5 seconds. The whole thing went from nothing to eruption. Hey guys, there is an event called CVX Live that I'm gonna be at August 3rd through 5th. Stage presentations, meet and greets, there's even a special superfan experience where we can hang out one-on-one. So click the link in the description and I'll be looking for you at CVX Live.